I would like to dedicate this little conversation to my goddaughter Zora Trinidad Otao, who's over there somewhere.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Can we say
believe in yourself?
Okay.
Together. 1, 2, 3.
Mixed Kings Radio, the stream of New York. In frontin' on this here, let's not even talk. All you haters speaking negative need to hush. Amanda Mandy, a personality you could trust. DJ Steve, cutting, making them gush. Performing with Public Enemy is something to discuss. Hot Breath Mario, got them all in a huss. Show your love or get thrown under the bus. Steve International, Mac Deliverages. Could take a joke, but his contract is serious. Mario from BK, started in 88, a radio DJ. 6 to 8 p.m. Sunday evening. DJ Taz is someone to believe in. Yeah. MKZ has arrived, so get right. Woo! You can find me with the eyes of midnight.
Love in Kenya. And it's important to be at a space like the Black Comic Book Festival, particularly at the Schomburg Center.
MixKingsRadio.com.
I like to do. When I see it on the film, I make it to reality. So anything is possible.
The new kid on the block.
Hey, New York City, Philadelphia, Baltimore, Maryland, and shout out going out to the tri-state area. Here we are at 135th Street in the heart of Harlem. Shout out going out to Claudette St. Rose of Believe in Yourself. She's going to be your host today, but I just want to take a moment to thank all those who have opened up doors for me. Since moving here from Brooklyn, New York to Harlem more than 30 years ago, thank you so much to all the people. You know who you are. From the DJs to the MCs, from the MCs to the party planners, from the cameramen to the camera women, to all those I stand on the shoulders of. For all those who are no longer here with us. Oh man, the Don Cornelius, the Kirks, and the people that know who I am talking about, the past, the present, and those who are coming in the future. And with that said, what brings me out today is the Black Comic Con. Man, you don't know how comic books changed my life. When I used to read Stan Lee, Jack Kirby, man, those books taught me to read. And you know, one thing about being in school, nobody likes the smart kid. That was me. Shout out going out to my second grade teacher, Mrs. Clark, who looked into my heart and saw what kind of character I was. I wasn't a funny person, but I was definitely a leader type of person. Had no problem reading in front of the class, and when you're in the second grade, you don't know what you're capable of until when you get older and you find out, hey, I've been doing this my whole life. And with that said, if you're watching this episode of Believe in Yourself, thank you so much for out of all the videos you could be watching. Thank you, thank you, thank you so much for watching this. If you'd like to see more videos, you can go to youtube.com under hashtag DJ Mario TV, or just continue watching on Facebook. And again, on behalf of myself, Claudette St. Rose and her family, and my extended family, thank you so much for watching and continue to support. Believe in yourself.
Hello, everybody. This is Claudette for Believe in Yourself video, and I just got here to the Schomburg. It's snowing.
It's lit.
But you know what? I don't even care if it's snowing. I'm just excited to come out here and see my people. My people.
Let's go.
Doing great things.
Thank you.
Speaking about great things, I mean, I just love this shirt, too, and the eyewear. Yeah.
So
what is that? Tell me.
So this is a mashup of two characters that I really love, Vegeta from Dragon Ball Z and Punisher from Marvel Comics. And I kind of figured out, you know what, let me put those two characters together because they're my favorite, and I made a costume out of it, and, you know, this is it.
This is hot.
What's your name, my brother?
What's your name?
My name is Yannick Flores. I'm an educator and actually teacher at the Schomburg.
Do you really? What do you teach?
So I work with the Junior Scholars Program here.
Really?
Yeah.
And, you know, speaking of Junior Scholars, I'm all about education. I mean, you can get me to stop. I speak about my kids, Maya. Maya, speaking about Junior Scholars, Maya is at Georgetown University. This is my daughter, Maya.
Nice.
And she is finishing up her junior year, and she's on the Dean's List.
Let's go, Maya. Congrats, Maya. Keep it going.
And
Black excellence.
Here, the other part of it. Maya went to Georgetown, not on any scholarships for athletics or anything. It's strictly scholastic. Just want to put that out there.
Black excellence.
That's what it's all about. But I just commend you, my brother. To the young people, what do you have to say to the young people that you teach?
Never give up on your dreams. Find your power and keep going.
find your power and keep it. What is your name, my brother?
My name is Yannick Florist.
And how can people find you? Are you on social media?
Yes, you can find me on Instagram at Uncle. That's UNKOO_NICK. That's Uncle Nick.
Are you on Facebook?
Yes, Facebook Yannick Florist. That's YANNICKFLOREST.
Because I want to tag you on this video.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
Fly.
Thank you.
Anybody that speaks about kids and education and kids doing great things has a special part in my heart.
Thank you. Thank
and you
me.
Just earned
Thank
that part in my
Thank
heart.
You. Thank
but
you.
On three, let's just say something, you and I. Let's just say believe in yourself, because I believe that if you don't believe in yourself, how can you have somebody else believe in you?
It word up. With word,
you.
Word.
Isn't that a fact?
Word,
All
word.
Right, so on three. One, two, three.
Believe in yourself.
Let's
just do it
say
again?
So that can... Okay. Yeah, let's okay. say, let's do it again.
Okay.
One, two, three.
Believe in yourself.
Let's do it again. Yeah.
Okay.
One, two, three.
Right. Believe in yourself.
And then let's just say so that others can believe in you.
All right.
One, two, three.
Oh, softly or?
No, let's do it.
Okay, all right, all right.
One, two, three.
Believe in yourself.
So that
others can believe in you.
That's awesome. Yeah, let's do it. Let's do the whole thing together.
Okay. My bad.
Yeah. Yeah. One, two, three.
Believe in yourself so that others can believe in you.
Everybody, I'm finally in the building, the Schomburg Center, for the 8th annual Black Comic Festival. This is just a great venue. I'm excited. There's so many people to see. There's the Black Sands Entertainment, and I just saw an action figure that I really want to talk to, but don't take my word for it. I'm going to walk around, and I am just going to bring him in. Just stay with me. How are you, sir?
I'm doing good. How you doing?
Great. So you are. Tell us who you are.
Of course, no. I'm Cyborg DC. Don't get it confused.
Cyborg DC. I love this. How long have you been doing this?
Well, actually, this is my third year. And each time I do it, I have so much fun. Last year, I did Black Panther to represent. I'm doing Cyborg. A lot of people kind of tend to, like, far as think it's a lot of work, but I made this by hand, piece by piece, glue, paint. But I just have fun to put smiles on kids' face. I just love it.
This is what it gives me the joy. How long did it take you to do this?
Total, it took me about 3 months to make.
3 months.
3 months.
I like, because you really put a lot of thought into what you were doing, and the end product is just really astounding.
Definitely.
It's amazing.
Thank you. And you know what? The thing is that when you watch a movie, they do computer graphics. My thing is, my joy is to make from the graphics and make it to real life. That's what the art that I like to do. When I see it on the film, I make it to reality. So anything is possible.
So between this outfit and Black Panther, which is your fave?
Well, you caught me off guard on that one. Black Panther.
Black Panther.
Yes.
So since it's your, let's do Wakanda Forever.
Yes.
One, two, three. Wakanda Forever. Where can people find you, my brother? Where
You can find me. You can definitely find me at Instagram. My name is Linton, Leo Linton. So it's LINTONLEO, Instagram.
Are you on Facebook?
No, I'm not, unfortunately.
You're not?
Only on Instagram.
Okay, because I would love to be able to send you the video. But this is what I'm on Instagram also. There's a page called Believe in Yourself, and I would like to tag you. So, you know, please look for me.
Okay, definitely. Okay. Definitely.
Thank you, my brother. Peace and blessings. Let me get a photo with you.
Okay.
On three, let's say Believe in Yourself.
Okay.
One, two, three.
Believe in yourself.
Thank you. Everybody, this is Claudette St. Rose for Believe in Yourself video, and I am here at the 8th annual Black Comic Festival here at the Schomburg. This is done every year, and I am just super excited because I see a lot of people that look like me doing great things, and I'm standing here with a beautiful sister. How are you?
I'm good.
What is your name, sis?
My name is Ellie Santos, and I'm the wife of the writer and creator of The Adventure of Assistant Admin, which is a series of 3 books. We're going to start our 4th book. We're going to start the Kickstarter in 2 weeks, about February 4th. So this is the story of an assistant admin who tried to get a job in a company to prevent hackers to hack the company.
Okay.
So in these books, you're going to find a lot of things that are going to be helpful for you. It doesn't matter if you are an assistant admin or if you are a regular person, because it's going to tell you tricks of how to prevent hackers to hack you as a person, because every day we're using technology, every day we're using cell phones, computers, and stuff like that. So it's a lot of that inside those books.
So it's more about preventing
how to
really kind of get around or stopping things from happening.
Yes.
In an office.
Yes.
Or in a company.
Exactly. More in the IT department.
This
is more technology.
So this, your husband, I know that he's busy over here, but when you get a chance, come on in, because I'd like to talk to you since he's the writer. Thank you, Ali.
You're welcome. Sí.
Saluda a la gente en español.
Muchas buenas tardes. Estamos aquí. También tenemos nuestros libros en español. Hemos hecho la traducción de los tres libros. Y es de cómo prevenir, es más la historia, es de un joven tratando de prevenir los hackers en una compañía.
Perfecto. ¿De dónde eres, Ali?
Somos de la República Dominicana, pero vivimos aquí en el Bronx.
Perfecto. Yo soy de Panamá. Déjame conversar un poquito con el autor. ¿Cómo estás?
Bien, bien. ¿Y ustedes?
Bien. Let's speak in English first.
Okay.
So we're standing here with the author of the books. I mean, I know you started. Which was your, show me the baby, where it all started. Which is the baby?
Number one, the beginning. Yeah.
And this is, tell us what is the name of the book.
The beginning, because it's the starting of the whole series.
Okay.
So that's
okay.
And how the main character got to where he is.
Okay.
Now, yeah.
Okay. The name of this book is Adventures of a System Admin. The beginning.
Yes.
This is where she's really sort of thinking about how to get into the company and
yes.
how to really stop the hackers from doing what they're doing.
Well, no, actually, he is this where he gets to the company,
so it's
and
a
then
he
get hired.
It's a he.
He get hired.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. He yeah. gets hired.
And yeah. then he start fighting the hackers that was trying to come to the company.
The hackers.
Yeah.
How long have you been doing this?
Well, around 2 years.
2 years. For those who are watching, tell people your name and where they can find you.
My name is Juan Espinosa. You can find me in Instagram, Facebook, Twitter at Gordy Don. And my books are in Amazon, Apple stores, and online in my store.
Thank you. So people can find you online and at Amazon also.
Yep.
And your other books, you have another new book that's coming out, so that's already in the making.
Yes, we're going to have a Kickstarter in about 2 weeks. It's going to be also in English and in Spanish.
Okay, awesome. Well. On three, let's just say Black Comics Rock, because that's what we are. One, two, three.
Black Comics Rock.
Thank you, my
Thank
brother.
You.
Hello, Mr. Bart.
Hey, how you doing?
I haven't seen you in a minute.
I know.
What happened? You abandoned ship.
No.
Basketball. What
no,
you doing? You've been
busy? I'm playing ball. Yeah.
You are?
Yeah.
Well, we miss you on Saturdays. Come visit.
I should, yeah.
Yeah, we have something next Saturday. Would love to see you.
That'd be nice.
Yeah.
That'd be nice.
So, you know where it is.
I do know.
The polo ground. Would love
yeah.
for you to come out.
That'd be fun. Maybe I'll stop by.
I would
Indeed.
Love that. It's from 10 to 12. You know the
Great.
Schedule.
Sounds good.
Awesome. And you have your
My
son with
he's,
you?
He's shy, though.
He's shy.
Yeah.
So what have you seen so far?
We just walked in. We ran into DMC.
Did you really?
Yeah, he's really nice. He
yeah.
gave us an autograph. Gave us an autograph of a picture.
Oh my god!
Illustration.
That is awesome.
Yeah, really nice of him to autograph. Really nice guy.
I just love coming here. This is my second time coming
okay.
to one of these Black Comic Festivals.
Yeah.
The first time I came, you know, I was a newbie. But I just love the energy, and I also love that all our people are doing such fantastic
oh, yeah.
work.
Yeah.
You know, and they need to be recognized.
Of course.
Know?
I've had I had a couple of friends who were exhibiting here as well, too.
Yeah.
And I'm an artist as well myself. So,
oh, you are. That's
oh yeah, I am. So I like coming here and getting inspiration.
And getting new
and supporting
ideas.
Black artists.
That's what it's all about.
Yeah.
That's what it's all about.
Yeah, that's great. It's
awesome.
Really cool.
You want to give a shout out to your son? Even
okay,
he's
shout out.
Over there.
Shout out to my son, Gervais.
Hey, Gervais. Shout
Gervais,
out to
Gervais.
You.
Gervais.
Gervais. Shout
Gervais.
Out to you.
Yeah. And it's always great to see you both.
Thank you. Let's just say believe in yourself.
All right.
1, 2, 3.
Believe in yourself.
I am standing here with Dedrin.
Yes, ma'am.
Dedrin, how are you?
Doing well, young lady. Hope you are.
I love what you have going on here.
Oh, thank you.
You know, you're very artistic, and I like this. I noticed there's a whole lot of posters. Are you the
One of several, but really I'm the content creator and more the writer. So I've got
a team of content creator. You're the guy with the brain.
Yes, and then you know, try to be. It's on.
Yes,
sir.
So tell me about a book that is really, really one of your top books you've really put content into.
Yes, ma'am. So I think
and what you know that everybody's really looking at.
Okay, thank you. So with that, we have our main series, which is Sorghum and Spear. It's an African fantasy about young girls that grow up during a time of monsters, and this is the last generation of them before they're wiped out.
Okay.
They have to learn from their mothers how to use their powers and be their best self.
I like that. I wish my mom had taught me how to use my powers. Things would have been different. Well, I have some powers.
You're right.
But they're not all developed. I'm still working on the powers that I have. Yeah, and other than that, tell us some more about it.
Yeah, so basically we follow a series of a couple of young girls who are just growing up and don't know that monsters are real or that magic exists until they find them in their lives. So with that, the young girls are not only growing up to be warriors, but growing up to be women. And from there, we tell the story of the decisions that they make influence the larger story around them.
I love that. That's powerful. Mm-hmm. So show me one of your bestsellers.
Well, I would say with that, a great... though this is not in the series, I'll show you this.
Okay.
And because we want to talk about the sisterhood is the superpower of the storyline.
Okay.
So even though these women and young girls have swords and spears and things like that, we talk about that them finding friendship and collaboration to both all be the best that they can be is really how they'll win and survive in the end. So we want it to be a narrative for young women, particularly young women of color, to know that not only their self-worth, but to see that the intrinsic value is something that the world needs.
I like that. You're encouraging not only sisterhood, but you're encouraging people to really believe in themselves.
Absolutely. Yes, ma'am.
You know? And that's who I am. Believe in yourself.
You go.
It's all about uplifting our people.
Absolutely.
Making them know that they're also are valuable.
Of course.
All valuable.
Absolutely.
Because God makes no mistakes.
That is true.
Is that correct?
That is absolutely true.
Where can people find you, my brother?
Yes, ma'am. So folks can find us at sorghumandspear.com.
Okay.
You can find us online at Green, GREENE, Co-Create on social media. And we'll have a new platform called Subsume launching soon.
Are you on social media?
Yes, ma'am. On social media, my name is Dedrin Sneed. That's DedrinSneead. And I'm out of Atlanta, Georgia, again with Subsume Studios.
Okay. What do you have, words of encouragement for young women? Because I like that you're focusing on young women. Because unfortunately, a lot of our young women, they either feel they're not beautiful enough, or they feel that there are things that are wrong with them. Again, God makes no mistakes, and we're all beautiful people.
Absolutely.
Whether we look one way or another.
Right.
So what words of encouragement do you have for our young teen that are growing up? There's so much peer pressure.
Exactly. I would say being able to look in the mirror and see your best self every time is the best thing that you can do, not only as a team, but throughout your life. And that looking at building your own self-worth and value and finding the talents and things that drive you and that you're passionate about is the best way to uplift yourself and also be a beacon for others for hope.
I love that. On that note, let's just say believe in yourself.
Believe in yourself.
That's what it's all about. Let's
Absolutely.
Say it together, my brother. 1, 2, 3.
Believe in yourself.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Have it, everybody. You just never ever know who you're going to run into, what is going to really catch your attention. 8th annual Black Comic Festival. I had the time of my life here. I met David Crownson, who has a book about somebody that is so instrumental in our lives. Harriet Tubman. Can you imagine a series about Harriet Tubman? So listen, you have to come out and be inspired because that's what it's all about. It's about supporting our people and really seeing where they get their juices, where the juices flow to really do what they do. I had the time of my life here, and on that note, listen, you know how you can reach me. You can reach me on my page, Believe in Yourself video with Claudette St. Rose on Facebook. Or you can, you can also reach me on my email, cvsgea at yahoo.com. There's so many ways to reach me. If you can't find me, it's because you're not looking hard enough. It's all about believing in yourself and inspiring and finding what really makes you tick, finding that little hump to really push you to the next level. And you know what? Glad I came, glad I saw. I made some new friends. I discovered a few things that I really love. I'm gonna say goodbye and thank you to Schomburg Center for allowing me to come here and see all this talent in one room. For all those who follow me, love you guys to pieces. I appreciate you. I'm out to my children. Wakanda forever. Harriet Tubman, the demon slayer. I love you guys. Until next time, this is Claudette St. Rose for Believe in Yourself video. Ciao. I'm out. Sure.
My son, it's